In the case of mercury, there is no safe dose of mercury. And it's an interesting concept. Some poisons in this world, you can get to lower and lower levels, and finally you reach a point where there just simply isn't enough around to cause disease. Well, in the context of mercury, the problem is the element mercury is toxic. So inherently, if you have a single molecule of mercury, it's toxic to human, to a cell, whatever it is. The only question is, how much damage does it do? In other words, how much damage do you need to clinically manifest with something that we call disease? And of course, where does that occur, whether it's the brain, the kidney, the heart, whichever organ? So the element of dose when it comes to mercury is only a function of how much clinical symptoms you have or how many people are damaged by it. So it's a very different kind of poison. And it's interesting in the context of mercury that we understand how susceptibility works, why some of us are more susceptible than others. The main susceptibility is related to ability to excrete mercury, which goes back to the element itself being poisonous, meaning that if you put mercury in a human body, the body can't break it down. That's the definition of element. It's the most elemental state, so the body can't chew it up, can't modify it, deactivate it or something. All it can do is eliminate it, excrete it. And so the body makes a substance called glutathione. Glutathione is a very sulfur-rich compound. Mercury likes to bind onto sulfur. And this glutathione that's inside of our cells, in our blood, when we have mercury exposure, the glutathione goes and scavenges, means binds up, the mercury and excretes it out through the feces, out through the urine, even to a certain degree through hair. And what we find is that there is tremendous variability on the amount of glutathione among individuals.